Breaking news from WA, the border wall has finally come down after nearly 700 long, long days. Live to Nine's Hayley Francis, who was on board that first flight into Perth this morning. Hayley, a big hello to you. Lots of joyous reunions there. What was that moment like?
Alex, there were a lot of tears, as you can expect, and it was always hard not to join in at times. There were so many people rushing out of the arrivals gate here, running into the arms of loved ones and just holding each other because now they can. People were holding each other for what felt like minutes. This is the first time in almost 2 years WA has brought down this border wall, and it makes such a difference to those who have felt disconnected. The conditions for travellers arriving from interstate and overseas are that you need to be fully vaccinated if eligible. You need to have an approved G2G pass and you need to return a negative RAT test within 12 hours of arriving here. Now, the flight we were on was packed. People couldn't wait to get here, including Anthony Albanese. He is hitting the campaign trail over here. But take a look at what were some very precious moments that we're very lucky to witness here today.
Oh, finally.
I can't even put into words. I have goosebumps down my whole body. I can't even put into words how it feels to be back in my home after 3 years of trying to make this moment happen.
We're just so excited to see you.
Alex, there are more and more flights expected here in Perth today, so plenty more reunions to come.
Brilliant stuff, Hayley. I can't wait to get my wife and kids over there. They've never been, so now we can finally do it. Well done.
Let's look. So you're going too?
I'm going too.
I sound like you're putting them on a plane and sending them on their own. Just glad we clarified that one.
I'm really glad we clarified that.
Well, Australia has finally become one again. Fortress WA opening its doors almost 2 years after sealing itself off from the rest of the country and the world.
To discuss, we're joined by today medical expert Dr. Nick Cutsworth in Canberra. Doctor, good morning to you. Nearly 700 long days closed off from the rest of the nation. Was it worth it?
Well, at some degree it was worth it, of course it was. I think the question is that, you know, for some of that time it was keeping people safe and for some of that time it was simply keeping people apart. So I do think that it went on for too long. Obviously it was the right policy to keep WA safe early on, but the good news today is that West Australians, you know, I'm a West Aussie from way back, and West Australians can go and visit friends and family and loved ones and attend those critical life events now.
I don't know though, Nick, because you have been a little critical of Mark McGowan. He may make an exception for you, and he may not let you in.
He might not let me in, but I think I've spent more time there than him. I was certainly there since I was 7 years old, so ooh, I'm going to claim more West Australianhood.
Sting. Hey, look, there are plenty of restrictions in place. There's still, I mean, I think it was yesterday, about 1,700 COVID positive cases they recorded. Masks for kids year three and above. Your thoughts on that?
So I think it's an unfortunate policy to be bringing in at this time with such high vaccination rates. When you've got the adult population and the elderly, grandparents well cocooned in the protection of vaccination, we have to question why we need the masks in primary school age children. And of course, 6 out of 8 chief health officers in Australia think that we don't need it. So certainly WA and Victoria finding themselves in the minority in that decision.
Okay.